Gwendolyn Brooks. On June 7, 1917, in Topeka, Kansas, the great Gwendolyn Brooks was born. She was the first child of David and Kezia Brooks. At just 6 weeks old, during the Great Migration, her family moved to Chicago, Illinois. During her grade school career, Gwendolyn attended three different high schools: Hyde Park, a top white high school; Wendell Phillips, an all-black high school; and Englewood High School. She also began a career as a writer and published her first poem, Eventide, which was published in American Childhood magazine. This feat was accomplished by the age of 13. Gwendolyn was highly influenced by James Weldon Johnson and Langston Hughes. After meeting them, she was encouraged to read modern poetry and write every day. Within the next 3 years, she published at least 100 poems as an adjunct member of the Chicago Defender. After graduating high school, she attended Wilson Junior College, where she graduated in 1936. Her early school experiences helped mold her into a great writer. In 1938, Gwendolyn became involved with a group of writers who wrote for Harriet Monroe's still-extant poetry and magazine of verse. She also married Henry Blakely, and by 1951, they had two children, Henry Jr. and Nora. In 1943, she won the Midwestern Writers Conference Poetry Award. In 1945, she became an award-winning author with her first book of poetry, A Street in Bronzeville, which immediately brought her critical acclaim, as she was later selected as one of Mademoiselle Magazine's 10 Young Women of the Year. She also won her first Guggenheim Fellowship and became a fellow of the American Academy of Arts and Letters. In 1949, she published her second book of poems, Annie Allen, which won Poetry Magazine's Eunice Titchens Award. In 1950, she received the Pulitzer Prize and became the first African-American to win the award. Gwendolyn continued to pile up awards until she died. She even managed to receive an honorary degree as a Doctor of Humane Letters. In 1962, Gwendolyn Brooks was invited to read at a Library of Congress Poetry Festival by President John F. Kennedy. Later in 1985, she was appointed Poetry Consultant to the Library of Congress. In 1994, Gwendolyn was selected by National Endowment for the Humanities as the Jefferson Lecturer. This award is the highest award given by the federal government in humanities. She began teaching in 1963 at a poetry workshop in Columbia College in Chicago, Illinois. She also taught creative writing at a plethora of schools such as Northeastern Illinois University, Elmhurst College, Columbia University, Clay College of New York, and the University of Wisconsin. In 1967, Brooks awakened her activism in her business life as well as her personal life. She attended the second Black Writers Conference and was inspired to become a part of the Black Art Movement. She became a visible and powerful ally for the Black Arts Movement. She also broke loose from major publishing companies to Black-owned publishing companies. Critics say her writing took on a different tone as she became more of a leader in the movement. Gwendolyn died on December 3, 2000, of cancer in Chicago, Illinois. She was a dedicated Chicagoan, writer, and champion for African equality in the arts. Gwendolyn was a success from her first piece of writing until her death. Ms. Gwendolyn Brooks, we stand on your shoulders.